Hey everyone, so today I'm going to be sharing 4 tips with you to getting kissable lips, because I do get a lot of questions about that, believe it or not. And so I'm going to share 4 little tips with you, along with some color for lipstick tips and a new company that I came across. So first and foremost, the number one tip is to exfoliate your lips. Now, there's products you could buy, and I have one here that I'm going to show you. But you could also make your own. You could put a little bit of sugar in your hand and mix it with a tiny bit of water and then use it as a scrub on your lips. This, I know I did a review on this a really long time ago, but I still use it. This is a Soft Lips Lip Polish. Now this basically does the same thing. I love the feeling of this. So it looks like this. The light's kind of shining on it, so it's kind of hard to see. But you can see I've used a lot. You just dig your finger into it and you scrub it all over your lips, so it's kind of gross. But then you just rinse it off with water and it leaves your lips feeling so, so, so smooth. I've always used this. I've never actually tried the sugar and water, but I assume it's about the same because this kind of has like a grainy texture. But this you could get wherever they sell soft lips, drugstores, Target. For really inexpensive if you don't want to make your own, but if you do, you can do that too. So exfoliating your lips is going to get rid of all that dry, flaky skin on your lips. The next thing you want to do is polish your lips. And to polish your lips, all you have to do is use a chapstick. It's going to like moisturize your lips, make them really soft. And if you use chapstick before you put on any kind of lipstick, it's going to fill in any little cracks on your lips, and that is just going to kind of make your lipstick look like it's gonna give it a smooth kind of appearance. Okay, so number 3 is pretty simple. If you smile, I read on something, there's some article on Yahoo News, because I have a Yahoo email account, so I always read their little news articles on their front page, and there's one about like kissable lips, and it was talking about like just smiling and stuff. So smile lots. I always like to smile. I don't know why, but yeah. Okay, so the last tip is to add color to your lips. And this is just, whether it's just with a pencil liner or lipstick or lip gloss, it'll hide any imperfections on your lips. For guys, it says facial hair will hide any imperfections, even though I'm not a big fan of facial hair. But so today, that is what I'm going to be showing you, because I have been venturing out of my no lipstick for Courtney campaign, and I've been trying out new lipstick, and I've actually been wearing it more often. I mentioned that in like my last haul video. So I am going to be showing you a cool company today called Ellis Boss. It's pronounced like that. I don't know how you would pronounce this. This is Ellis, but that's Boss. I wish it came with like a little thing on how to pronounce it. But so they have 3 different colors. They have the creamy lips, the milky lips, and the glazed lips. So they sent me a lip product from each of those 3 categories, and I'm going to tell you what I think about it. And they did also send me different colors. So I'm going to show you what colors I recommend. And so the first one I'm going to start out with is their signature color, which is Ellis Red. And they sell this color in all 3 categories, the creamy, the milky, and the glazed. This one itself is in the milky. So this is L201, if you could see that. Okay, so I am pretty pale right now. Haven't really tanned in a while. And this is kind of dark on me just for my skin color. But they claim that their red, which is their classic, is like the perfect red, because a lot of reds are kind of hard because there's so many different tints of red. There's ones with blue tints, and so there's this, they claim this is pure red. And so they give you a little tip to applying this color, and they say to apply in the center of your lips and then kind of blend it outwards with your finger, or you can just apply it all over. So this is the milky lips, and it looks like this. So you just twist the bottom and some of the product starts to come out. So I'm going to use my little mirror here, and I'm just going to apply it. What is nice, I look ridiculous, what is nice about these brushes is you could get right in here into your Cupid's bow. Really nicely. Okay, so now I'm going to blend it out with my fingers. So as you can see, it is very, very dark on me, and it's even darker when you apply it to your whole lip and don't blend it out. Now this is something you have to be a red lip person to wear this. I'm going to zoom you in. So yeah, I mean it's really pretty if you can actually pull it off, but what I do like about this, I wore it one day and it lasts forever. Like I ate, I drank, I did all that, and it lasted a really long time. So since it is so dark, what I like to do is take a tissue and blot it off just a little bit, just like that. It kind of takes away the darkness from it, and you know, this next color is the glaze color. And it is in the number 308, and this is kind of like a more nude color, and I don't like the glazed as much just because I don't really like lip glosses as opposed to lipstick. I don't really like all the gloss, but there is a way to fix that if you don't like the lip gloss. This I don't, with my experience, it doesn't stay on as long as the other two I got, just because I guess it is more of the glossy texture, but this has vitamins and omega 3 and 6 in it. And so this, the only thing I don't really like about this applicator is that it's kind of hard to get like around your lips perfectly, so you have to be really careful. So I'm just going to finish now since the dog is barking. I really like this color though. It's really just like a natural kind of nude color. Just got to twist it to get a little more product. I don't want to twist it too much and have all of it explode. And they also, while I twist this, they also sell little holders. So I like the way they're shaped. They're really like sleek, so they almost look like pens. And you could just, it comes with holders with little holes, and you just stick all of them in there so you can see the top and see what color and number it is. But feel like you twist forever with these things. Just keep twisting, just keep twist. Oh, there we go. Now it's gonna like explode out on me. There we go. So now I'm gonna zoom in for you guys so you can see this color a little better. So this is something I would definitely wear on a daily basis because of the color. It's really natural, but you could tell there's something there. And to make it less glossy and more of a matte color, more of a lasting, you also do the same thing with the napkin. And it'll take away some of the gloss and